treehouse is set deep in the jungle. I get a lot of animal friends visiting, but not many people.
My best friend Rosie has arrived for a treehouse sleepover! Yay! This is going to be a stack of fun! Come on up, Rosie!
Once upon a time, deep in the jungle, there was a girl who lived in a tree.
That's why they called her.
Where, up in the jungle girl. Where, princess of the animal world. The croc hunter taught her, now his only daughter.
PJs, Fredo. And yours, Peru. Tawny's already asleep.
Welcome to my treehouse. Tonight I'm having a sleepover with my best friend, Rosie.
I'm so excited, Bindi.
Me too. We've got heaps of things to do, like pillow fights and movies.
Dancing and singing.
And my mates, the Crocmen, are sleeping over as well.
You must have had so much fun filming Bindi the Jungle Girl in your treehouse.
You bet. Take a look at this.
My dad was always unpredictable as much as the animals.
And one of the best times are when my dad... Oh, honey. Coming up after the grape. Sorry.
Sorry, sweetheart.
Dad was just kidding, but he sure had me fooled. To my brother Robert, filming means playing.
He's a big egg.
He is like a big egg.
How many are
there? Here I come, Robert.
Thank you, Robert.
He really enjoys spending time with snakes.
Hang on a minute. Is this the snake here? Hey, what do you think? Is that fun?
No.
Filming for the episode Ocean's 10. I had such a good time setting up the Crocmen with a freak wave. But I had no idea how it would backfire on me.
Whoa, Bindi! Watch out for that freak wave!
They're huge. My dad swam with one, but boy, did it make a big wave. Splash.
It's pretty bad when you can't trust your own mother. And sometimes I nearly grossed out on the bugs. I really like mealyworms, but they feel really icky when you have them wriggling all over you.
Thank you, lovely.
They're all on my shoes now.
A handful of crickets is not a good feel.
Don't squish them, don't squish them. These crickets live for only 2 months. Okay, get them off me. Crickets live only 2 months. There's one on my shirt.
Where?
There's one on my shirt.
Where?
On the other side. Okay, all right. Someone just dead.
Bugs, I love them.
Crikey. Crikey! Did you know tigers are able to keep their claws razor sharp for hunting by pulling them into a protective sheath when they don't need to use them?
When our big cat Juma the tiger came up here with my dad, he nearly wrecked the treehouse.
Getting a tiger up into my treehouse was the first big hurdle, but letting him get used to his new surroundings was a much bigger challenge. For Juma, it was like being in a toy store and everything was fair game. He was having the best time. For a tiger, if you can't play with it, eat it. That's the next best thing. But it was obvious that Bindi's globe was the winner. And just look at the teeth marks. Still awake, Fredo?
Peru is so quiet.
Are iguanas dangerous?
No, not really. They're very, very patient animals. Unlike the big cats that are very tricky.
Big cats are always on the alert, which makes filming quite a challenge.
Always have, always will. I remember the very first time I saw a cheetah. Celebrate cheetahs on Action Big Cat. On Action Big Cat. Yeah, he's on ya. Have a look how happy and relaxed they are.
Just as you said that, he went.
Did you see that?
Action.
Have a look how relaxed Juma is in here, and all the cats love it in here. The Tiger Temple was custom built.
To the tiger, my dad was just someone new to play with.
Jerry from North Dakota has asked how I go to school when I'm away from home. Well, Jerry, I take my school and my teacher with me.
Wherever we go in the outback, Miss Emma sets up our classroom in the great outdoors. It's beaut for first-hand nature studies.
Squeeze the, like, silk out of it and out of their larva, the baby. This is a bit of schoolwork that I did, describing the things about the green ant. Like, the green ant is small and it bites. And I've done a little picture of Daddy going, my dad to help me with these ants. Hey, Dad!
Yeah, babe?
Can I have some help with these green ants? They don't bite at all, trust me. If you could just hold the branch for me.
This one?
Yeah, yep.
And they don't bite?
No, they don't!
They actually bite and sting, but let's not tell my dad that.
Oh, oh, oh! I thought you said they don't bite, Ben.
Oh, they're just treating you. They're just saying they love you, Daddy. They certainly do love you.
Coming up next, we go dancing and singing with the Croc Man. Da 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 da!
Go to sleep, Prue.
Fun in my treehouse. I have fun filming outside too.
Best friends.
Being a field reporter in Tanzania, Africa, sounds like a fun assignment. But for my mate Caleb, it was his first job on camera. And trying to say Serengeti and remember how many wildebeest gave us these great bloopers.
We're here in the Serengeti, Jacob. There are over 1.5 wildebeest that migrate across the Serengeti. There are over 1.5 million. There are over 1.5 million wildebeest. Serengeti covers over 12,000 square feet. Serengeti covers over 12.5 square miles of Serengeti covers over 12.5. The Serengeti covers over 12.5 square miles and We're only allowed an hour with the chimps, and an hour, and our time is almost. We get so close to them that they live. Oh my God, no!
I don't know what to say, John.
Meanwhile, back in Australia, in Kakadu National Park, my first attempt at being a field reporter wasn't much better, as you will see.
Our up-and-coming wildlife documentary presenter, Bindi Earle, over to you.
Hey, Dad, there's a sand goanna running in between.
Can I say in between the geese?
Whatever. Go.
Hey, Dad, there's a sand goanna running in between the geese.
It was a lot of fun.
Check this out. Over here, big poo. Oh. Now, you gotta look at it. A good wildlife presenter holds your hands out.
Don't you dare throw it at me.
I wouldn't.
You're gross. These geese. Ah!
Did you know trees live in houses made out of people? They like to branch out.
Guess who else has just arrived at my treehouse for a sleepover?
Minnie!
What do you think, Rosie?
Very
yellow.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Paul, this is Rosie.
Hi, Rosie.
Mark, this is Rosie.
Hey, Rosie.
Troy, this is Rosie.
How you doing, Rosie?
Hey, Rosie.
This is Rosie.
Hey, Rosie. So, Bendy, where are we going to sleep?
Yeah, where are we going to
sleep?
Well,
you guys are sleeping downstairs in the bunk beds. And we're going to sleep upstairs in my room.
Hey, Bendy, you guys still practicing your singing and dancing all the time?
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, cool.
Awesome. And Rosie's a good singer?
She is the best singer. She has the most beautiful voice.
Remember when we were singing in the studio?
Yeah, it was awesome.
So much fun.
I just love singing in Mark's studio.
My dad was get up and go, sheltered the animals just like Noah. He's still a household name in our house.
Okay.
My dad was a great man, a park conservationist, park Tarzan. He knew things he would teach me, like how to surf a wave down the beach. We'd ride a motorbike, we'd pitch a tent, yeah, tie a water fight just for fun. Traveling the world was a big adventure. Living with my dad was a bigger one. Catching snakes, jumping.
Did you know
that 1 in 3 adults in the United States is overweight?
That's over 60 million people that need to lose weight.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Did you know, Rosie, that when we were learning the dance steps, it took a long, long time to do it? We also had to get up really, really early in the morning so that we could go to the dance studio. And our choreographer, Dale, she helped us learn all of them. And, well, we got it all pretty easy, but, well, except Chris. They call him Chris Cross.
When the hip bone was hurting,
Chris needed a lot more practice than the rest of us. If you watch closely, he's always dancing the opposite way to everybody else. He reckons he's the only one in step, and the rest of the blokes are way out. Nice try, Chris. I think he's dancing to a different tune.
She looks a lot shorter.
Dancing is not only good fun, it's great exercise to keep you fit and healthy. I love it.
When she opens up her mouth, she sings.
And when all the rehearsals are finally finished, it's time to get the show on the road.
And I'm much larger than you.
Next, we uncover some strange creatures in our files.
This is Tony the
tawny frog mouth.
Sheesh, she's great, but a bit strange.
Yeah, I get to handle a lot of strange creatures filming this show.
I love Texas, and I love the Texas lubber.
This little grasshopper is called a lubber, a Texas lubber. And it tastes horrible, just horrible. Okay. Successful release.
I just love bugs. Yes!
These salamanders are just like frogs. They're amphibians. They go through the exact same stage as frogs. They go from a tadpole to all those different stages.
Aren't they cute? They've got these cute little beady eyes. Look at their little legs. It's really cool because they don't really have toenails.
She's always smiling. Have a look at that little gob there. Aren't you very cute?
A strange encounter in Colorado. Down under in Australia, the outback is covered with flies, and they don't seem to worry about state borders.
There's a lot less flies in South Australia.
Yeah.
Or is there more flies in South Australia? This is how many flies are in South Australia. This is how many flies are in the Northern Territory.
Yeah, I think it's about the same.
About the same?
Mm.
Are the flies going up your nose?
Yeah.
Flies even love going to the beach.
Have a look at this beautiful.
These flies just love my dad's cockies. But I found the best way to keep flies away is with a tree branch, an old trick my dad taught me. Or in extreme cases, you can try outrunning them. The one thing I really find annoying is when they get in your eyes, nose, and mouth. That's really yuck.
Rosie, this is Jenny, the Burmese python. They can grow to 20 feet and they live in Southeast Asia.
Do they shed their skin?
Sure do. Two or three times a year as they grow bigger. But my dad learned a neat snakeskin trick in Denver, Colorado.
We're off to the Alameda East Vet Clinic in Denver, Colorado, where vet Dr. Kevin is showing my dad his special snake trick on a pet Burmese python. Using sticky tape on the snake's eye will help lift off a piece of stuck skin from its last shedding. As a snake gets bigger, it grows a new skin and discards the old one. But sometimes the old skin sticks to the snake's eyes. If this happened in the wild, the snake would just rub its eye on a rough surface to clear it. But in captivity, people sometimes have to help out. What a simple and painless operation for the snake. My dad was impressed.
The sleepover continues.
And I catch crocs too.
He's a baby alligator. He's about 1 year old.
This bloke is about the right size for me.
Rosie, I've actually helped to wrangle a saltwater crocodile 500 times bigger than Alex.
Crikey!
We're joining my dad's croc research team in Cape York, North Australia.
As soon as we get these top jaw ropes on, we're gonna see some girl action, all girl action.
First, my dad has to rope the jaws of the croc so it's secure for us to jump. This is a job he always did himself to make sure it was safe and no one else was put in danger. Once the croc's secure, it's all aboard.
Bindi, get that tail.
Hold on to it.
Okay, we got legs.
Okay. I've lost me little helper. Robert, you got the duct tape. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, up!
After the satellite tracker is attached, it's ready for release. This is the most exciting time, but I'm well clear before the croc is let go.
We're sleeping over tonight. We're sleeping over tonight. We're gonna dance, dance, dance. Don't you know we're gonna have a pillow fight and play, play, play to move all over.
The best part about a treehouse sleepover is a pillow fight. What a beauty!
We're having a sleepover, yeah. We're having a sleepover.
documentary presenter, whenever you make a mistake, it's always captured on camera.
G'day. I'm Steve and this is Terry.
This was the first camera test my mum and dad ever did, rehearsing the opening lines to their first TV show.
G'day. We're Steve and Terry Irwin, and today we're going to take you on a wild adventure. Tonight.
Crikey, they were better at wildlife than remembering lines.
No, another one? We're getting the hang of it. G'day. Welcome to Wild Adventures.
Tonight we'll be going to...
Sorry, I might introduce us. I'd like to welcome you. Okay, here we go.
Good night, Troy. Good night, Mark. Good night, Chris. Good night, Paul.
Good night, guys. You've had a really big day, so get some really good rest.
Good night, Bindi.
Good night, guys.
I've had a great time and I've learned lots too. Thanks, Bindi.
Sleepovers are especially good in my treehouse because I've got lots of animals. Always look after wildlife. We need it for our future. We'll see you next time for more fun in the jungle. Bye!
Be the Jungle
what my dad's boat, Croc 1, is like. Well, Johnny, it's a working boat that has all the comforts of home.
In Northern Australia, Croc 1 is in Croc Country on important croc research work.
This is my dad's croc research vessel. Come on, I'll give you a tour. This is where our diver, Chris, drives the boat. It's called the Wheel. Show you the fly bridge. And now we're going to go check out the boat that helped us catch the croc. And that is our boat, which is very, very muddy, as you can see. From up here on the top deck, you can see all the way down the river and up the river.
Occasionally, we get little tiny bugs and things like this on the boat here. He's so gorgeous. This is a stick insect. He's also called a praying mantis, and he sways in the breeze so that all of his predators thinks he's a leaf or a stick. And the other reason why he was hiding on this grey anchor is because he's sort of a greyish colour and he thinks, oh, I can blend in on here. This is a perfect top spot for me.